Hey guys, it's Gary
and Eric
with Upton Bass. Here we're doing a removable neck modification for a bass. I'll put a few points along this red line, maybe with yellow. Don't know if that'll help you. I'm going to take a couple close-ups with my cell phone in a minute here. Eric's laying out the center line, and I walk over and I see the neck joint.
Yeah.
And the thing is sideways.
Depending how you want to measure things, there's two or three possible center lines.
So like, what's the middle of the bass, right? Like, did the maker put the eyes of the F-holes floating out in virtual reality and then paint the rest of the bass around it with its C-bouts, upper bouts, the neck block, the end pin block, the saddle? Eric just did a video where he's talking about how he designs a bass, or how we design a bass. And we're talking essentially from the bridge, which is impacted by the string length, which you guys need to be a number of, we're saying around 41, right?
Yep.
Plus or minus an inch. So 40 inches, 41 inches, 41 and a half, 42. These are numbers widely accepted.
We marked out initially the center of the neck mortise.
Yep.
At the start of the set.
But if he takes the bottom in assumption of it being, you know, square to the instrument, which is original to this bass, that line starts kicking way over here.
Right.
This is not a rehearsed shot. We just kind of want to working and doing this stuff. It's like, heck, let's show people. So let's say the center of the bass there. And the dog's crying in the background. Luna, lay down. So, yellow China marker here, you got that?
Yep.
Look where this thing's pointing. That's that yellow line I just drew. And then where Eric's marking it out down the bottom with the right angle.
This is where the confusion comes in. When I'm looking at the center line of the bass versus what's called the acoustic center of the instrument based on neck set and bridge position.
So what, you're off, what, 3/8 of an inch or so right there.
Mm-hmm.
Never mind once he actually hits where the bridge is gonna sit. So can you see this red line and the yellow line? So yellow's virtual center, right? Red's probably more actual acoustic center. Imagine how far off your bridge would be if we put the yellow line as your center joint. So all of this matters when he's setting the neck. If he sets the neck in the wrong direction and then the neck's adjusting, start to get kind of crazy land.
Yeah. If I set the neck so that it's pointing where the bridge should be based on the F-holes, it's gonna be pulling off to the side and it's gonna look off the center line. If you take from the F-holes up, what's crooked about the bass is the whole lower bout is kind of off center this way.
And this guy's going that way.
Yeah.
Countering it, right? When the guys are making the basses on the molds, they're starting square here, they're starting square here, everything then is based on here. So you could take a measurement in the same place here, measure up to, you know, essentially, I'll do an imaginary line, but if this line intersected in the same distance from here on the neck block, like so, and Jack does this number when he's figuring where the bridge is on the bass. Again, we're doing this very crudely, just for example's sake on the video. What's this number? What's this number? So this, again, it begs the question, like, where do you start? Which he talks in the other video about where you design a bass. Bridge, neck joint, end pin block,
okay.
Artistic.
In talking with the owners about the bass, one of the complaints about the instrument was the tone, the unevenness of the tone. And when I started looking at it and talking to her about it,
it made sense.
Some of those, like what she was telling me about the tone was kind of, you know, consistent with the offness of the set in the unbalanced tension. And that was actually her words, unbalanced. The bass felt unbalanced.
But we have to take those infinite variables that all really kind of get into that psychoacoustics, legitimately psychoacoustics. And we have to define some of these elements, right?
Yeah.
So on this bass, I think, tell me if I'm wrong, these F-holes are essential. The table right here is going to define where the bridge is going to go.
Yeah.
The bridge is then going to define how the neck sets, so that her strings are hopefully equally pushing with pressure on this bass. You know, then you get into a whole other mind-blowing element, right? Where's the bass bar? And that starts to be another defining element. What if he can't put the bridge where he wants?
The beginning of looking at a project like this and trying to decide where you're going to go with it, and all the different factors that you have to figure out in the decision making to get to where you're going to go, and then the end result, it has to feel, play, be comfortable to the player, and then stand the test of time.
And you still know at the end it's not perfect, right?
Like, because what is perfect?
Yeah.
What is perfect?
Yeah, round circles, things that are off. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed it.
All right, thanks.
See ya.